The search for truth. Do I have freedom here to search for truth and teach it to my students the way I used to before the oath and all these things came in? Freedom is such a nebulous word. I don't know what you mean exactly. You'd have to define your terms. I teach the way I always have. But you know how it is. One goes on learning. One grows more experienced. One's taste becomes more disciplined. One realizes that the young are prone to take things literally. And so a gradual approach to truth is sometimes indicated. It seems to me a choice of values is involved in this whole question of so-called academic freedom. The public hires us to teach the young. Well and good. Would it then be fair for us to betray the public trust and teach our students what the public does not approve of? Clearly not. And furthermore, we are dependent on the public for our support. At last, our salaries begin to match those of professionals in other fields. And should we jeopardize these gains with ill-conceived, quixotic claims to be a law unto ourselves? Each year, the legislature votes for us another 3% increase in pay. And look around you at these buildings, our new gymnasium, our stadium. These mean we have the public's confidence. I wouldn't want to see this sacrificed. I don't think you would either. My attitude about the Mitchell case? My opinion is that Dr. Mitchell, for all his undoubted brilliance, is not a man of tact and showed less judgment than a full professor should possess. The police force, as we know, is far from honest, riddled with corruption, if you please. What city's force is any better? But to send one's students over town, sticking their noses into everything with questionnaires, not even leaving out the brothels. This was too much. He put the institution and his colleagues, to use a vulgar term, upon the spot with that investigation of the links between police and prostitutes. That kind of thing is not our business. We should concern ourselves with the eternal verities and not the ephemeral passing show. We see events in true perspective only generations after they occur. And all this hue and cry over academic freedom will surely seem a tempest in a teapot a century or two from now. Of course, it is a shame that Dr. Mitchell had to go. He'd published many books and was a credit to the faculty. May you quote me? Oh, no, indeed. I meant no criticism by my remark. It was a wise decision to dismiss him. I just meant, really, I didn't mean a thing, but Mitchell was my friend. Don't quote me, though. I want that off the record.